If I don't post for a while, people will reach out to you and be asking, is everything fine? Is everything okay? Funny enough, even when I feel like I'm going through something, I still post, you know, because I don't give myself excuses that, oh, okay, I'm going through something. I'm not post. This is my business. People think that, oh, as you're posting, you're making money. No, it's only YouTube that actually pay you. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. If this is the first time that you're joining, I want to say a very, very big welcome. My name is Oma. I'm a content creator, and in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys tips on how I create content on Instagram, YouTube, and every platform really online. But first, before I actually continue this video, please check the link below to access a free course that is going to be teaching you as a content creator about creating content. Some of the things that I probably will not be saying in this video, I'm going to be saying it in that video. So click on the link below to access that course. It's free, 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 guys. The first thing I actually do that really, really helped me is that I plan. You can tell yourself that, okay, I'm gonna post once a week, twice a week. It depends on you, so you need to plan. Ask yourself, how consistent can I get on this social media platform? For me, I decided to be posting every day, right? And it's not like it's every time that I keep up to that, because sometimes things happen, maybe you'll be busy, you know, because I'm a student, I'm still schooling. So if school activities starts now, I have to go back to school activities. People think that, oh, as you're posting, you're making money. No, it's only YouTube that actually pay you. Like, as you're posting content on YouTube, they pay you. But for other platform, you have to sell something. So you either sell like a course, or you sell like a PDF, you sell your book, you have to sell something on other platforms. But for YouTube, they actually pay. So if you're thinking of making money online, you have to sell something. The second thing that I do that helped me is that I take my pictures like in a day. So if I'm like, okay, I'm gonna be posting pictures every day, I will like change my outfit. So like if I can take like 5 pictures or 10 pictures in a day, you know, and because I want to have the best quality, I have to take them over and over till I'm like, okay, I like this. So all I have to do is I have to change my outfit to the outfit that I like, and then I take a lot of pictures with that look. So with my makeup look, I can change my outfit and people will know. They will think that, oh, okay. They will think that, oh, it's because I was taking it every day. No. Who has time to be taking pictures every day? For me, it doesn't work for me because I'm just someone that I just have to shoot in a day. Even my videos, like some of the videos I post, I'll probably just shoot like in a day and shoot so many videos and just have them in my archive and something like that, so that I will not get tired. You know, so many people start YouTube and they get tired, and they're tired of posting, and that's because they overwhelm themselves. Just do things like in a day and just plan, okay? So when I've posted pictures and I've posted videos, I actually ask myself, do my audience like this video? Do they like this? So if they like that, I'm going to do more of that. So I do more of the things that my audience like. So you need to know what your audience like, and you need to do the things that your audience like. If your audience really engaged with that picture that you've posted, then you will know that your audience wants more of that picture. So that means you have to post more of that picture. You know, people engage with my videos, but a lot of people engage more with my pictures. I think it's because I decided to put more effort with my pictures. Like, I got someone to help me edit my pictures, even if I have to pay them to edit it. Yeah, I know I have to pay them, but it's worth it because I know at the end of the day, I'm an influencer, right? And in future, brands will reach out to me, will pay me to promote their products. So now this is like my little beginning. So this is my little beginning. Do not despise little beginning. I'm still growing, right? Another thing that get me consistent is the fact that I really love being online. If you don't like being online, I'm telling you, just be tired, you'll be overwhelmed. I'm not the going out kind of person. I love being indoors in my room and just playing my phone, reading, doing stuff in my room. The next thing that helped me to be consistent is the fact that when you post and people reach out to you and tell you, oh, I love this, I love that, and they want more of your content, somehow it makes me to keep posting because I'm not aware of the fact that they want more of the content. If I don't post for a while, people will reach out to you and be asking, is everything fine? Is everything okay? Funny enough, even when I feel like I'm going through something, I still post, you know, because I don't give myself excuses that, oh, okay, I'm going through something. Let me not post. This is my business. I have been consistent on this online platform for the past 5 years, more than 5 years. I know that this is something I love and this is something I decided to take professional. Like, I'm not playing with it. I do what I'm supposed to do. And anytime I'm like, okay, I need to take a break, I actually do take a break. The best way to make money is to actually make money from the things that you love. So if YouTube, if social media is a platform that you really love and you see yourself that you want to make money from this platform, then you should actually just go into it. You should start posting. I know a lot of people, they say, oh, I want to post, I want to do this, and I don't know, they keep giving themselves excuses. They start with, oh, my phone, I don't want to use my phone, the quality is bad. Oh, I don't have a camera. Oh, the sound is this. They always give themselves excuses, and I feel like, see, stop giving yourself excuses. Just start with what you have, and with time, you enjoy it. It's just a fun platform that so many people come to showcase their gifts, to showcase their talents, to sell their business. A lot of people are making millions from social media. So you don't want to just deprive yourself of making that money also. You don't want to deprive yourself. So you want to keep posting, you want to be consistent, and you want to grow your audience. It's very important. The moment that your fans start liking you, because you're going to grow if you keep posting every day, if you keep posting every time, you're going to grow. Tony Gaskin was actually the one who taught me how to post every day, because I was just wondering, he was always posting like every day on his YouTube channel, and I'm just like, how does this guy even do it? Like, he's always posting every day on his YouTube channel. And then he was just talking of how that was actually how he started, and that's how he grew his account. So you should always know, if you are thinking of starting like a YouTube channel or any platform, then you need to know that consistency is very important. If you start today and then you stop, they will forget about you, because there's so many people, like there are so many other people posting, and then they will go to other people and watch what they are posting. So keep being consistent, never give up. Okay, so that's it for the video. This is what I do that helped me to be consistent on Instagram, on my blog, to keep posting. Yeah, this video, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to get the free course. Just sign up and then you can be able to access the free course. I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.